She's been part of the Welcome and Wellness family for a few years now, and she's seen a lot of changes, and she's very talented. So we're very lucky to have her here tonight. So let me introduce Riley Weir.
Waiting for time to pass you by. Hope the winds of change will change your mind. I could give a thousand reasons why, and I know you, and you've got to make it on your own. But we don't have to grow up, and we could stay forever young. Remember from poor sipping on a soda underneath the setting sun. I could give a thousand reasons why, but you're gone, and all you have to do is stay a minute. Won't you take your time? The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do is wait a second. Put your hands on mine. The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do is stay. All you have to do is stay. You won't admit what I already know, that I've never been the best to let it go. I don't wanna spend my life alone. Guess I need you, and I need to make it on your own, but we don't have to grow up, and we can stay forever young. Swinging on the front porch, sipping on soda underneath the sun. I could give a million reasons why, and you know that all you have to do is stay a minute. Won't you take your time? The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do is wait a second. Put your hands on mine. The clock is ticking.
My name is Margarita. For those of you who don't know me, I'm the tech CA here at Welcome to Wellness. The other night I asked my six-year-old daughter, I go, Eliana, why do you get adjusted? She said, well, to make my body healthy. And I thought, that's the right answer. That's a great answer. And you know, I thought about it and I go, well, this is how we start to create healthy communities and society, by teaching our children and leading by example, right? They mimic what you do and they copy it. Tonight, Dr. Phil, unfortunately, Dr. Emmer won't be here. She's ill. She really wanted to be here. Dr. Phil is going to be talking about how to raise a healthy family using the five fundamentals of health. Who knows what those five fundamentals are? Anybody going to help me? I'm going to start. First one is? Yes?
Mind,
yes. Mindset. Second? Oh, you got it there. Okay, yes. We got mind, nerve supply, lean muscle and oxygen, nutrition, and minimizing toxins. So all five fundamentals we know work together for optimal health. And that's what we all strive for. Our mission overall, not just Welcome to Wellness, our mission is to create the healthiest community in Canada, right? Making Durham Region one of the healthiest communities. So, and we do that by helping one person at a time, that leads to one family at a time, okay? Now I'm gonna introduce Dr. Phil. He's been a chiropractor in Durham Region for now, this year is gonna be 25 years. I'm not done. he's been helping thousands of families lead a healthy lifestyle. He's helped newborns to professional athletes. Okay, so now without further ado, welcome Dr. Phil.
Thanks very much, Mark. Hey, Brian, can I just bring you back for a sec here? I want to brag about that. Okay, so we'll come on this side. So they're telling me, because they're recording Facebook Live. So you did an awesome job. I mean, that's amazing. It gives me, I don't know, when singers are amazing, they give me goosebumps and my hair is on as it was when I heard the first time that you sung. We've got a YouTube video there. So I just want to say that Riley, you know, she's an actor. She's a singer, as you can tell. She does dance. She's into different sports. You know, she's on the honor roll. She's in grade 8 right now, but it wasn't always that way for Riley, right? And so back in grade 1, so back to grade 1 when she couldn't focus in class, by grade 2, you got put on the ADHD meds. You couldn't focus. And then what happened was, a couple years into it, I'm not sure when the symptoms started, but you started to actually feel like digestion. You didn't feel like eating. You didn't really feel yourself, you said to me. So if any of this isn't true, you just pipe up and tell me. But basically what you said is that now, you said, well, I can't digest my food. I don't feel hungry. I just don't feel myself. I couldn't communicate with others the way I normally would. And some people, you didn't describe it as a zombie like, but some people describe it that way. So you were even questioning, was it even working for you? And then fast forward, then you started to come in between grade 5 and grade 6. You started to get adjusted. You know what we found? What did we find in the first visit of your visits here?
I didn't have a curve in my neck, so nothing was filling up my head.
Yeah, so this part of your neck, so it wasn't allowing the brain to do its communication properly down. And it, as it turns out, it affects neurotransmitters. We'll tell you more about that. So now you notice that there's been an improvement. You were able to get off the medications, which is congratulations for you.
Okay.
And so what we ask people is, if Einstein and Thomas Edison had have been around today, they would have the same symptoms. What would they have been put on? Probably the same medication. And if they were kept on it, maybe we wouldn't have the light bulb. Maybe we wouldn't have the theory of relativity and all the things that they created. So for you, I think, well, maybe we wouldn't have the superstar right here being her best. And that's really our mission, is to help people become their best, to live life to their fullest, to their God-given potential. And I think that's a fine display of potential right there. Did I miss anything, Mom? Did I miss anything on that? Or anything to add? Riley, I gotta give you a hug. Thank you so much. That was so awesome. And I would love to have you back as a guest singer again. So hopefully when you make it big, you're gonna have a chiropractor on your tour, right? All right, so that's awesome. So what I want to do is hopefully we'll see how this goes. Yep, fantastic. Okay, so I'm lucky enough to be a co-author of this book, and we're going to share some secrets with you. We're not going to keep them secrets tonight. There are so many resources for this. And so, Diane, I'm going to ask you after if you can pull some of those up on the computer, the resources. So our mission is to help you live your highest potential that you can. But in order to do that, we have to educate you about what health and healing really is. And we need to change people's mindsets on how they view and manage their health. That's really because most people are doing certain things, but they're not following our five fundamentals. They don't even know about half of them. And so I'm asking, why is this so important in this day and age? Don't you think that we're getting better as a society with health, and especially in Canada, don't we have one of the best healthcare systems in the world, right? And arguably we do. However, what's happening with the rates of disease for kids? Is autism going up or down? Are more kids being put on ADHD meds and psychotropic drugs? We'll talk into psychotropic later. Are more kids being put on inhalers like I was on for 9 years? What's happening with antibiotic use? Is it going up or down? When we even know that antibiotics don't help a lot of infections now, and it's going up. And we're going to be giving you life stories today that will change the way you view and manage your health for sure. And so it's alarming right now that from 2000, the stats with autism are showing that they've doubled in about 16, 17 years. And Dr. Senev has calculated that if it keeps going at the rate it is now currently, that by one out of every two kids by 2025, there's a possibility by 2025 that they'll have an autism spectrum disorder. All right, that's alarming. Whatever that number is, we know it's going the wrong way. And so back 25 years ago, when I started practice as a chiropractor, we didn't see kids having plaque in their arteries. And now kids are having plaque in their arteries. Now we're seeing they're having high blood pressure. We're seeing they're getting type 2 diabetes, more common than ever before. We didn't see it in kids. It used to be called adult onset. Now it's called type 2 because kids are getting it. It's staggering. I didn't see 25 years ago, I didn't see kids on their x-rays showing arthritis like in their teenage years. I'm seeing that now. And there's reasons. We're going to discuss why that's occurring. There's reasons why it's happening. And we know we can actually prevent that. So the good news is there's hope. That's the best thing. You know, like Riley's a perfect example about breaking out of her shell, so to speak, becoming her best. And that what happens is that there's two real thoughts to health. There's two philosophies of health, two paradigms of action. So I'm going to ask you right now, when you enter the healthcare system, right, when do you first go to a doctor, especially children, when do they go? Yeah, they most of the time go when they're already sick. So from our wellness perspective, is that they're already behind the eight ball. I want you to think of a health spending account, like a bank account for your health here. And so by the time you reach symptoms that you can see here on this line, by the time you reach these symptoms, then we think you've already depleted your health account and you're going into an overdraft situation. So what happens when you go to the doctor? And they're going to take your symptoms, and they're going to put it into a label, and they call it either a condition or a disease. And what do you normally get for that? We get a medication, or possibly a surgery, or more medications, or so on. So we just discussed how that's working for many diseases or conditions. It's not really helping that much. In fact, the rates are getting worse. So what our thought is, instead of fighting the actual disease, we want to build your health up. We know that there are five determinants of your health. That's why we call them the five fundamentals. And our mode is not to fight the disease or the symptom, but to actually build your body up so we can be healthy, so that you can be at your best ability. And so these building blocks, we call the five fundamentals. I want to share an example, like cancer. So I think most people know, do we have cancer cells in us at all times? And so what stops the person from walking to this side and getting on the disease side and having the diagnosis of cancer and having that take over their body? What's the difference between somebody else on this side having cancer cells but not having any troubles with function in their life? What is it in our bodies that takes care of the cancer cells? The immune system. So instead of in medicine, they will attack the cancer, the pathogen. They'll give it chemo, radiation, they'll cut it out. And I'm not saying don't do that. I mean, thank God we have doctors on this side of the line that will help you in a crisis. Okay, we're not saying don't go, we're not saying don't use it. But what we're saying is that will never build your health. It can't build health. In the bank account of health, the savings account doesn't go up when you take a drug. It actually goes down. So it helps you recover from that illness, but it never actually, you know, adds to your bank account or your health account. And so in our model, we are actually going to find what is stopping your immune cells from fighting that cancer. What's stopping it? What are the five things we test and measure? So when you come to our office, we'll actually test you and measure as to what that is. And so that's the difference between building health. We don't fight cancer. We don't treat cancer. We don't treat back pain. We don't treat asthma. We don't treat anything. We build your body up so it can do the job to be healthy. That's the difference. That's the wellness philosophy. So these five fundamentals are vital to you becoming your health. And I think that if I ask people, if we put almost anybody on an exercise, if anybody went on an exercise and a nutrition program, would their health improve? What do you think? Do you think so? Yeah, it's going to go up. So what do you think anybody, if I put them on a nutrition plan and an exercise plan and it was better than what they had before, would anybody go the other way and go towards disease, do you think? You think that's possible? Well, in the lifestyle medicine guidelines, of which I've taken my certification through Harvard Medical School, so that what we know is that exercise is the number one thing that's been shown to help every disease. There isn't one disease that you can name that exercise doesn't help, and the research is staggering for that. Nutrition's similar. And so what we know is that the mindset is important as well as exercise and nutrition. And so I want to talk about the mindset here, because many of the kids come in and they think that they have a condition. Like myself, I thought I had asthma and that I had a condition, and that just some days when my asthma was bad, I just wasn't going to be able to run as fast as the other kids. Right? So people with ADHD might be saying, I just can't focus. I've got this condition. Well, it's just my condition. And they think that they have no hope to get better. And I want to tell you that's furthest from the truth. The truth is you have somebody like, you know, Riley here who's built her potential up. You have somebody like me who I thought that shackles were coming off. You know, and if you were listening to that song that when you came in, what was that song I was playing by the Canadian artist that just won a Juno Award?
Nothing Holding Me Back.
Nothing Holding Me Back. All right? And so that's what I feel. I think Riley feels the same. It's awesome. So that's the mindset. We're going to coach your kids to not take that label, to make sure that they don't know that that's a handcuff, a sentence for life. It's not. They can break away from that. And better yet, wouldn't it be nice if we could check the kids from birth, right? So like Margarita talked about Eliana, she's been checked since she was 1 week old. My kids were checked. My wife didn't even hold them first. She gave them to me. Can you imagine giving birth to your child and telling your husband, make sure you check them to make sure that their spine is properly moving and functioning so that their brain can send the signals down? That's love. All right. So detoxification is another one, and I just want to talk about what happens. So detoxification, just to back up here, detoxification, I think people know that toxins are prevalent now. The kids today growing up, the environment, the air you breathe, the food you eat, the toxins are so available now, or, you know, there, present, compared to when I grew up even. The toxins were way less then and compared to our grandparents and so on. They've even measured now the toxins go through generations, so that when they measured the blood of kids at birth, they're measuring toxins that were banned 30 years ago are still in their bloodstream. They have many toxins to deal with. But I want to talk about the most underrated factor, fundamental here, is the nervous system. And so Deepak Chopra, one of my favorite authors, in his book Quantum Healing, he says that your body has a wonderful pharmacy. Inside, it can make antibiotics, anti-cancer drugs. It can make hormones. It makes, in fact, everything. And it makes it for the right dose, for the right organ, for the right time, with no side effects. How cool is that? Is that pretty cool? So what controls all that? You can call it innate intelligence, as Deepak Chopra says. You can call it God, life force, Mother Nature, whatever you want to call it. What is in control of your body working properly? Your brain, that's right. Your brain, and that's why our fundamental two is the most often neglected, because in medicine, when you go and get a checkup, do they ever check how your brain's controlling your body? Do they ever check the signals up and down? And the answer is not too often, only when you need neural surgery, pretty much, when it's devastating damage. And so we have a test, we measure that, and that's why we think every single child should have a checkup from birth, and we're going to show you why. I'm going to give you tips and stories about what you need to do. So you see, when somebody, best case is that we prevent it from the first place. But what happens here, if you read along here, this is the lifestyle medicine guidelines. So if you have a condition like I did with asthma, or Riley's condition, what we're going to do is we're going to write a letter to your doctor, because we don't take you off the medications, okay? We don't want you to go off like haphazardly. There has to be an organized way to do it. And so in these, there are guidelines in lifestyle medicine that say, when you're on our five fundamental program, this is how you do it. We send a letter to your doctor, and the doctor, catch this, when the underlying lifestyles are addressed, patients are often able to stop taking medication and under their doctor's supervision. Likewise, they can often avoid surgery as well. Does that sound hopeful? To me, it sounds hopeful. It sounds like you have a choice in your health on how you're going to be healthy or not. And so in the case of psychotropic drugs, and that case with ADHD, it might be that you're going to take that to alter the way you think. It may make you calm down, but it doesn't allow you to be creative and be your best. You see how creative we have as an example tonight. For me, the chemicals opened my airways, and thank God I had those, because I wouldn't have breathed without the inhalers. One of the toxins was propane for me. Back then, the propane was a propellant, besides the other chemicals. So you can imagine why I detoxify myself, okay? 9 years of propane in my lungs. So this allows us, this Dr. Bragan has a guideline for how to come off these medications, and we follow that for people on psychotropic drugs. We know that healthy kids are going to model healthy adults. But unfortunately, unhealthy adults are going to act as a mirror, and the kids are going to follow them. So people think that it's all about their genes, when in fact, we know the research shows 5 to 10% of conditions are due to your genetics. But what we know is that even though you might take after your father or your mother or your cousin or whatever, it's most likely not your genetics, it's most likely that you're eating the same way that they did. It's most likely that you're exercising or not exercising the same way. You've got the same habits of your lifestyle. That's the more likely cause, what the research is showing. And guess what's under your control? Your lifestyle. It's totally under control. That's why I get excited about this, because we know that it's under your control. The immune system, we talked about that with cancer cells. Most of the childhood illnesses now, diseases that are getting worse and worse, that are we're trying to fight with, manage with medicine, they're getting worse still, is because they're immune system problems. Type 1 diabetes, asthma, allergies, you know, these things with eczema, the gastrointestinal problems. We know that what's happening is that your brain doesn't recognize your own body's cells, and it will attack them. Part of it's toxins. Part of it's because your brain doesn't get the communication down. So what we're going to do in the wellness, remember the wellness philosophy, is to find out where you're going wrong with the five fundamentals. What's stopping you from building the health? So that's what we look for. And so we know when it comes to these immune diseases that it all starts from birth. Even before that, because the research is now showing that, and we've got these resources, all of these things that I'm saying are covered in our resource section. And so, Diane, I'm going to have you put that up at some point before, probably when I get to the nervous system, okay? So they can see where to go on our website. So you'll see about antibiotics. You'll see about how your first, as a child, when you come out through the birth canal, that you're actually ingesting from the front section from mom, if you go out live through that way, and you're ingesting from the back section. So there are microbes, microbiome. Anybody heard of that word? Good. The microbiome, and most people know probiotics. You heard about those? Okay, so those are the good, healthy, you know, there are bugs living in us. In fact, there are about as many bugs in us as we have our own cells. And most of them are residing in our gut. We have them on our hands, we have them all over our skin. So when you take the antibacterial soap and you wash that off, do you know what the research has shown? It's shown you're more likely to get a worse infection because you've taken the one layer. So it's like a gang, a turf war. This gang that's normally on your skin, it's there, it's actually helping you from having other worse gang come in and take over. So the worst pathogenic bacteria you can put in your mouth, but the regular bacteria, they don't cause you problems, and you start using things and interfering with your body's ability to be healthy, then there's trouble. Interference comes from antibiotics. When you're actually the mom and you take the antibiotics, it shows that the microbiome, those 70 or 80 trillion cells in your gut, they actually start getting destroyed when the mom takes that, and then she can't transfer that natural microbiome through the birth process. And so what they thought was is that your microbiome will replenish itself. And now the recent research is showing that they're not sure if it replenishes itself. Maybe if you're taking the fermented foods and the probiotics as supplements, that will, it will come back to normal. But they're not sure right now. They're doing investigations. The one thing they know for sure is that the antibiotics destroy that. There, you'll find in the research section that taking antibiotics in the first couple of years of life, the first three, leads to a threefold increase of asthma as a child. If you took one course of antibiotics in the first 3 years of life, it leads to a threefold increase in asthma. Do you think I had antibiotics as a kid, as a young kid? I have them right from birth, okay? And so I'm not happy about that, I'm just telling you that's what it was. So, and people say to me, Phil, you talk about medicine so much, you know, but the problem is that about 60% of the people coming in that are coming in with symptoms that they want those symptoms to go away, about 60% of them are taking medicine for which the side effect is the very reason they're coming in. And that's alarming. And they did a study of 1 million kids, 1 million children, 18 and under. And this was done a few years back, and that's about 30% of the kids' population back then. They studied them for 12 months, so plus two. So 12 months, and what they found was is that about half the kids were on a drug that in that 1 year time frame. And what they found was that 76% of the drugs that they used were antibiotics. Okay, so this is very common. This is why I'm spending a fair amount of time on this. And that the 18% were like me with the inhalers, and that about 6% were on the psychotropic medication. They're now giving kids antidepressants under 5 years of age. Okay, so that's what's going on. That's the solution. So I'm going to ask you, does 25 and under drugs provided by your government? So some people say, they say, oh, the kids are going to have free drugs. And I ask you, are they free? Are the drug companies donating them out of the goodness of their heart? Okay, so it's coming out of yours and my tax dollar. So what I want, I don't want them to not have the drugs. That'll help them in a crisis. But what I want them to do is to know the truth about health and healing. And those drugs will never increase their bank account, their health account. It always depletes it. Okay? It may save them, and it may be useful in a crisis. So even more alarming to me is not the rate of use of the drugs possibly, but this fact. What they found was when they looked at the research behind the medications being used, what they found was is that for a large number of these drugs, safety and efficacy among children has not been established. What does that mean? That means it's experimental, and they don't know if it's going to help you, and if it's going to actually
really
be safe.
Test, they don't really test it.
They don't test it. That's what they're saying.
The numbers of tests are very small.
It's very small, yeah. Unfortunately. Now, we're not saying kids shouldn't have medications, but I want you to know as a parent, if you're walking in and thinking everything's scientifically validated, it's not. And so I want you to know that you have options. You don't have to take drugs. And I'll give you an example. When it comes to common infections coming up. But what I want to do is just take a look at the psychotropic drugs. About 6% of the kids 18 and under were taking it during that time, is that they looked at what are the adverse reactions with those psychotropic drugs, and what they found was 28 case examples of kids that had cardiometabolic problems. They had increased weight, they had increased blood pressure, increased cholesterol. So even if those drugs were associated with those problems, now what are those kids going to do when they get to the doctor? What is the doctor going to do with them, I should say?
Good morning.